The song you're about to hear is called Little Liza Jane. It was published in 1916, but was circulating in the Americas before that. There are vocal and instrumental versions, as well as versions in jazz, bluegrass, folk, rock and roll, and early New Orleans music. There's even a West African welcome song called Funga Alafia that shares the same melody. This version features banjo and is in the style of the early 1900s. Later, we will play our modern interpretation of the song.
Leadbelly's Cotton Fields Back Home was recorded in 1940 and represents a work song. Work songs were sung while conducting a task, often for timing, or the song was linked to a task.
When I was a little bitty baby, my mama rocked me in the cradle in them old cotton fields back home. When I was a little bitty baby, my mama rocked me in the cradle in them old cotton fields back home. When that cotton get rotten, you couldn't pick very much cotton in them old cotton fields back home. Down in Louisiana, about a mile from Texarkana, in them old cotton fields back home. When those cotton balls got rotten, couldn't pick very much cotton in them old cotton fields back home. And when those cotton balls got rotten, couldn't pick very much cotton in them old cotton fields back home. Now when those cotton balls got rotten, couldn't pick very much cotton in them old cotton fields back home. Down in Louisiana, about a mile from Texarkana, in them old cotton fields back home. It may sound a little funny, but you can't make much money in them old cotton fields back home. It may sound a little funny, but you can't make very much money in them old cotton fields back home. Now when those cotton balls get rotten, you can't pick very much cotton in them old cotton fields back home. Down in Louisiana, about a mile from Texarkana, in them old cotton fields back home. I was over in Arkansas, people say, what you come here for? In them old cotton fields back home. I was over in Arkansas, people say, what you come here for? them old cotton fields back home. Now that cotton balls get rotten, couldn't pick very much cotton in them old cotton fields back home. Down in Louisiana, about a mile from Texarkana, in them old cotton fields back home.
St. Louis Blues, written in 1914 by W.C. Handy, was the first blues song ever published. Ironically, the song is not a standard blues, but a blues with an interlude that features the habanero rhythm, or what Jelly Roll Morton refers to as the Spanish tinge. You can hear the trumpet and sax engage in collective or group improvisation on this recording.
Evening sun go down. Yeah, I hate to see that evening sun go down. Because the woman that I love, she done left this town. Now if I'm feeling tomorrow just like I feel today, y'all, if I'm feeling tomorrow just like I feel today, I'm gonna pack my suitcase and make my getaway. St. Louis woman, with all her diamond rings, carry that man around by her apron string. Now if it wasn't for Bada and all her store-bought hair, the girl that I love, she wouldn't have gone nowhere, nowhere. I got the St. Louis blue, I'm blue as I can be. My woman got a heart like a rock in the sea, or else she would not have gone so far away from me. Somebody play some blues.
The next song is Struttin' With Some Barbecue. Louis Armstrong recorded Struttin' With Some Barbecue in 1927. It was written by his piano player and wife, Lil Hardin. This song is one of the first recorded departures from collective and group improvisation and features Armstrong as a lone soloist.
Duke Ellington's big band first recorded It Don't Mean a Thing If It Ain't Got That Swing in 1932. The big band era is commonly referred to as the height of jazz as a commercial success. There were several big bands at this time touring colleges, performance halls, nightclubs. Many radio and TV programs at the time used a big band as its house band or default band. Vestiges of big bands can still be observed on late night shows.
The next piece that you'll hear is entitled The 219 Blues. It was originally called Mamie's Blues and was recorded in 1939 by Louis Armstrong. It's a great example of jazz musicians playing popular R&B songs of the day.
Took my baby away. Yeah, the 219 took my baby away. But the 217 will bring her back someday. Take the T&P and I'll take the L&N. Oh mama, I said you take the T&P and I'll take the L&N. Oh, we got to be lucky, honey, to ever meet again.
Charlie Parker recorded this next song entitled Ornithology in 1946. The song is a contrafact, which is a composition that contains a new melody written over the harmonic structure of a familiar song. Many composers in this bebop era, like Parker, wrote contrafacts over popular songs of the day. Ornithology is written over the pop hit How High the Moon.
I Mean You is a composition by Thelonious Monk, and it was released in 1948. It has a standard 32-bar form with a 4-bar tag. Monk's tunes are among some of the most played songs by jazz musicians. Lonely Woman was released in 1959 on the album The Shape of Jazz to Come by Ornette Coleman. Ornette was a relentless champion of the avant-garde movement in jazz and founder of the free jazz genre. This song is a demonstration of playing free, or free jazz, where the compositions and solos are not necessarily bound by form or harmony. In Lonely Woman, you can hear that most of the song is centered around the melody played by the saxophone and the trumpet.
The song So What is an example of modal playing. This song is on the album Kind of Blue, which to this day remains the best-selling album in the jazz genre. The piece has a standard 32-bar AABA song form, with one mode for the A sections, and the bridge or B section modulates up a half step. Thank you.
John Coltrane recorded the album Love Supreme in 1965. The opening composition in the suite is called Acknowledgement, and it is the song that you will hear. This is an example of playing modally, which again means improvising over one chord or one sound. At times you can hear the soloist and or the rhythm section modulating out of and then back into the original tonal center.
Mercy, Mercy, Mercy was recorded live in 1966 by Cannonball Adderley. It was written by his pianist, Joe Zawinul. It became a crossover success, blending R&B, gospel, and hard bop. This version of Little Liza is not dissimilar to how you would hear the song played on many bandstands in New Orleans. The groove being played is a combination of New Orleans funk and a New Orleans street beat, typical of modern brass band music.
The last piece that you will hear is entitled The Backward Step. The Backward Step was recorded on an album entitled Into the Blue in 2008 by Nicholas Payton. Nicholas started the hashtag BAM. BAM is an umbrella term, an acronym that refers to Black American music, and is often now used as a way to credit Black Americans for their contributions to American music. This track is a great example of the many influences that encapsulate Black American music. Everything from Louis Armstrong to hip-hop can be heard in the groove, melody, and solos in this song.